Okay, let's begin. Can everyone hear me? All right, it's my pleasure on behalf of PickNik Robotics to welcome you to the first ever MoveIt workshop here in Macau. And I know we've been through several days of ROSCON workshops, so hopefully we can keep this alive, especially in the afternoon. We'll have some more interactive things where we can get up and kind of brainstorm and do some hands-on pieces. So we thought about calling this MoveIt Con, but for this year we wanted to keep it modest and humble and not set expectations too high, because it's just a few of us organizing these things in the background. But first I want another acknowledgement to AWS for sponsoring this event. They've been very generous to the ROS community, and I was excited that they wanted to support us as well, so thank you, Amazon.
Thank you, Roger.
Roger's right here. And also, it's really important to remember that MoveIt's much bigger than PickNik. We're kind of an organization providing leadership to the community, but our contributors are very strong. So these are our maintainers, and you'll see that they're from across many different organizations and companies around the world. Particularly Robert Heisk, is he here yet? I saw him yesterday. Wanted to shout out to him. He's kind of our technical lead gatekeeper. If you ever get your pull request delayed, it's probably related to him. But he's really keeping our quality really high. Michael Gorner also has been a huge contributor, and the rest of the guys on this list as well. And then we have two layers of governance. Basically, there's the maintainers who have write access, and then we have a concept of core contributors who just we want to acknowledge for the great work they've done. And they join us in the meetings, and they are very active, and we hope that they become maintainers as well. Additionally, the original team stems out of Willow Garage, like much of ROS, so shout out to Sachin and Johan and Dave and Acorn for their original work back in the day. And for this workshop, Rob, who's in this corner here, has been pivotal in pulling this off. I talk technical details, and he does operations, along with Tani, who's back in the US, unfortunately, for this workshop. So if you have any questions today, please find Rob, and he'll unstick things. So our schedule for today, we have invited talks for the first half of the day from different organizations. And then a note on invited talks is that we do not have a particularly diverse committee choosing these talks this year. So next year, I want to really, and when we get bigger, we call this MoveIt Con, really get some of the other MoveIt community choosing who will be speaking. But today, if you don't like the talks, it's my fault and Rob's fault. other people at PickNik, so blame us. We have two coffee breaks. We have a lunch that's catered. And so we'll be going downstairs for that somewhere in this labyrinth of a casino. And then I'm excited about having our first panel discussion from some of the thought leaders in our community about where MoveIt's going and who our users are. We'll be doing a group road mapping where we're getting out of our seat, and we'll be kind of talking about the sticking points, the issues, because while we have done so much for MoveIt, there's always areas to be improved. We have a hands-on later in the afternoon, and finally, just like ROSCON, we're having our very own lightning rounds. So if you are interested in that, please send those to Mike in the corner here. They'll be organizing that. There's a sign-up URL right there, and you can email them or hand it to us on USB. For the hands-on section, I don't want to stress you out. If you're not interested or you don't have the proper computer setup, you don't need to participate. You can just listen in, watch what we're working on. But Robert will be leading us on actually using the task constructor, which is a new feature in MoveIt that we're very excited about, because it's a step above just motion planning. It's doing task planning, so it's combining multiple motion plans is the short of it. They'll explain it more later. But if you want to do that, it would be best if you install this now. It shouldn't take more than 5 minutes of download time. The core MoveIt is totally packaged up as Debian. We've been doing that for many years now, and so it's just an apt-get install. I think now it's just apt-install. I'm still used to that. But then the task constructor is hot off the press. I've been working on it the past year, so it's not released yet. So you'll need to clone two repos in your catkin workspace. And if that means nothing to you, don't fret. But this is, and finally, the Wi-Fi is here. It's also in the back if you need access to that today. A note about just the advanced aspect of it. The original intention of this workshop was to be a developer's workshop. And It's grown much bigger than we expected, so we were targeting 30. We've doubled that to 60. We're really excited to have all you here. People are still trickling in. But we want to allow some advanced topics to be discussed, because RossCon can kind of be high level and boom, boom, boom. We want to dive into some of the more focused discussion here on MoveIt today, but we'll do our best to, you know, ease into that, give you some background before going too technical. So in the past 2 days and 3 days of the workshop, if you count that, we've had a number of talks around MoveIt and around motion planning, so we won't be repeating those here today, or not too much at least. Mike yesterday talked about MoveIt Grass, which is a big new feature in MoveIt that we're excited about, and that'll be online if you missed it. Also, we have great tutorials for a lot of these aspects. There's also some work from other groups that are manipulation and motion planning, not exactly MoveIt, but we want to bring that into our fold. Like Reach uses MoveIt under the hood for some of their workspace analysis from Michael, and he'll be speaking later today too. So these are talks that already happened. Some of these guys will be speaking again today on slightly different topics. Again, why MoveIt workshop? I just hit on this, but it's supposed to be an informal day. We're not a con yet. Wait till next year. And expert advanced users. MoveIt is 8 years old, and I want to just underpin like how much community development and work has gone into this successful open source project. MoveIt's really grown, and we've had 230-something contributors on our main repo, but there's other repos too, growing and fixing and improving and adding features, and so it's really hardened at this point. In the open source world, 1.0 typically means it's like stable, hardened, it's a badge of honor. In the commercial software world, that means, oh, this is the first version, it sucks. But in MoveIt, we've this year finally released 1.0, and we had to do that because we're pushing on 2.0 now, but we're really proud of that we have a stable version. We've been doing long-term support releases for many years now, and it's something that we're really good at, almost too good at, is not breaking API and stability. And so on that note, last November 2018, I actually wrote an open letter to the community on Discourse that everyone could see about our intentions, my vision for MoveIt, and how, you know, PickNik, we're trying to be a commercial company supporting this open source, and we're growing a lot to it. But the vision for MoveIt is that we want to keep changing it and fixing it and breaking things because we don't want it to stagnate. So I want to remind everyone today of that intention. And so one of the big outcomes from since last year is we now have a master branch. And it sounds so trivial, but the standard in the ROS community typically is you have a melodic devel branch. We're developing for melodic or kinetic or noetic, all these different, you know, ROS 1.0 at least, ROS 1 distros. The problem is that most of these projects, including MoveIt, you create the melodic branch when you release it as a Debian to the world. And so when we released Kinetic, we said this is long-term support, this is stable, but we are also still developing out of that branch, which means that for the next 2 or 3 years of that branch's development lifetime, our hands were tied. We couldn't actually break anything because then we've already promised this is LTS. So we finally wised up, and now we have a melodic branch, which you can download today. We'll be using it in our tutorials, but we haven't actually added any major features to that because we don't want to break anything. It's stable, and we're doing bug fixes, and that's it. If you want to work on cutting edge, if you're a developer, if you're adding new features, work on master branch. And so master will become our noetic branch in 6 months when that's released. So, such a small change, but it's had a profound impact because we've seen the speed of development really increasing. And we want to encourage our volunteers, our grad students, our research groups in different corporate R&D groups to add as much as possible. And you know, sometimes it's okay to make mistakes, and we'll just patch that quickly with a bug fix. So I'm really seeing this growth of features. And sometimes we have to refactor major parts of it. So, The fruits of that, of all this effort in the past 2 years that we've really focused on growing MoveIt, are a ton of amazing new features that make our ecosystem vibrant and strong within MoveIt. And sometimes people even ask, like, so what's the difference between the ROS ecosystem and the MoveIt ecosystem? And so MoveIt is a collection of plugins that are, we're using the ROS plugin framework, but they're really high performant. And so a lot of times motion planning, you need to be able to sync between your collision checker and your kinematic solver and your planner and your graph generator, sync between those in really high rates, thousands of times per second. We want to have this running in a real-time fashion that ROS 1.0 really did not support us to. So The answer to the difference is that we use ROS extensively. We're very tightly connected to ROS, but we haven't distributed everything to the extent that it hits performance. And hopefully with ROS 2, we can move back away from that a little more because, you know, with a zero memory copy. But breaking into these features, you'll see here underneath there all the different contributors from around the world. Some of them are on the PickNik team. But breaking into them real quick, this afternoon we're gonna really get into the task constructor. It's this GUI on the right, and it allows you to, you know, introspect each step, and like, why couldn't it find a grasp here? Oh, it's because the null space of your elbow couldn't reach, and so we need to change the input trajectory goal. And so it'll tell you which grasps failed, which ones work. So it's a really interactive way. It's somewhat of a state machine, but it synchronizes the different tasks. And I'm gonna not nail it as well as Robert and Mike and the other guys working on this day-to-day can hit this on later. As we talked about yesterday, this grass library we've used for a couple of our clients. I started developing it many years ago for the Amazon Picking Challenge, but Mike's run with it since then and changed it where I don't even fully recognize it anymore. And this is all open source, available for you to get today. This C++ interface is, I don't know how to picture it, but it's an API, it's an interface. But there's been a lot of contention around Move Group, which is our high-level interface, but it has performance issues because it uses so much of the ROS infrastructure. And if you want a real-time system, you need lower-level control, bare-bones access to the C++. So this is a new API to running much more powerful applications with MoveIt, and so this is a standard that we're using across all of our client projects. It's purely motivated by feedback we've gotten from clients and from the projects we've built out, and we want to share that with the community. JogArm was presented yesterday. It's a teleoperation feature set that you can remotely control your arm. We're also using it for other sensor inputs, not just humans. So if you have a perception system giving you real-time Cartesian trajectory look to follow, that's available to you. Chomp's optimization-based motion planner, we now can smooth out your paths after O and PL generates them through Chomp or other post-processing adapters. And so Mark Mull, our head of research, will be discussing that shortly today, this morning. From our greater community, Felix has added new ways of dealing with name frames, and this was a very large pull request to get in, but making the way you describe things more flexible. Several new algorithms that are for more optimal motion planning, the velocity and acceleration curves, making sure that you get faster results in your trajectories. And this is super important if you're a factory line and you want to increase your throughput and get arms that are results that are more optimal. And so this is huge development. We already had several other algorithms, but we've been iterating on these based on cutting edge research from academia. And so this is an example that we continue the tech transfer from research papers to a platform that's used around the world. Levi, who I think is joining us today, I don't see him yet, he's been doing a lot of prototyping in the Tesseract project, and he's made a lot of suggestions of things that we can improve and MoveIt, and we've been very responsive to bringing those back into the MoveIt project. And so he's pushed a lot on TradJop, which has been amazing work, and TradJop required the collision checker bullet. We've brought all that back in. We've been sponsoring interns and Google Summer Code students to make sure that we're staying up to date. There's also some, in the past two ROS cons, some optimizations he suggested in speedups. We brought those back in with the help of our community. So we're really excited to be taking that feedback from other projects and growing MoveIt's feature set. And then the list goes on. I know I'm running out of time here, but Microsoft has added Windows support, lots of just speed-ups across the different areas that we've done. We focused on usability as well. The setup assistant is really what makes MoveIt so popular across the industry, across academia, is that we have this GUI that steps you through all the steps of creating a MoveIt robot. So you take any custom robot and get it running and MoveIt quickly. Well, we've added more screens to that wizard, to that setup, last summer. So now Gazebo has first-class support, ROS control, a number of amazing features that makes it easier. We've improved our benchmarking based on a lot of the client work we're doing, who they want faster plans. Cartesian planning has gotten a lot better in the past year or two with a bunch of requests from the community. Speedups, our other interfaces. finally, this last one's cool. It's a we've had many partnerships with industry for the MoveIt project. Real-time Robotics has a FPGA-based collision checker that we've added with their sponsorship, and it is really impressive results how fast they can do collision checking. In some sense, they kind of maybe are competing with our feature set in an open source project, but in the other sense, it actually works very smoothly with it. So if you need that type of reactive control, they have a really great solution, and we enjoyed working with them. Overall, I just wanted to show the high level of our ecosystem is incredibly feature-rich, so we have, oh, I see a bug here. So the global planners is, this is incorrect, that should be OMPL and SBPL, our global planners. And within OMPL, there's 20, 30 something planners more that you can use. So it's a library with a ton of other planners. But then we have the local planners that are more optimization-based. They're really powerful for getting you smooth and fast trajectories, but they get stuck in local minimum collisions. Our Cartesian planners are more the traditional way of doing motion planning. We have several solutions for that. The number of plugins we have for inverse kinematics, collision checking, grasping, it's really an amazing ecosystem of us iterating with different approaches, and we're not closed to any one of them. And then lastly, everyone talks about the need for documentation. Well, we actually do it. We had a collaboration with Franck Imica, a grant, where we spent several months just improving and overhauling our documentation. So this is the list of tutorials that you can currently see on our website. And there's actually more in pull requests that we haven't even launched yet. And we overhauled it. It used to use the PR2. That robot's no longer for sale. So we switched to a lower cost robot from Franck Imica, the Panda. And we're really excited. We've heard feedback from people who used MoveIt a couple years ago, and then they use it recently. They're like, Dave, this is so different, the documentation. And so you'll find all this here on, we have different versions of documentations, mastered, different distros, so that we have a clean way of changing API. We overhauled the website, and on the website, there's additional, more high-level conceptual documentation under the docs menu here, and also just lots of information about our standards. So you see, we've really hardened our framework. It's been tested on so many robots. Our early days at Willow Garage, it was ArmNav, and we did a full refactor for MoveIt. And since then, we've been rebranding with MoveIt 1.0. We dropped the exclamation point officially, so this is hopefully the last slide you see that on, and maybe our t-shirts that are misprinted. And then MoveIt 2 is on the way, and so Mike's about to give us an update on that. We have an alpha, is the short of it. A quick timeline of all the things since 2008. Our first release was in 2011. We've been in every release, major distro release of ROS since then. And so we really have a very long history of quality software coming out. Our stats that I like to always tout is we've searched the internet long and hard for how many different brands and models of robots have used it. We found 152. I asked Tolly the stats on MoveIt Core, which is our main package, 23,000 downloads per month. In Google Scholar, you'll find this 542 times, so it's been really used in research. And unlike a lot of the infrastructure of the ROS community, MoveIt really is a lot of algorithms and cutting-edge theory that it's complex. It's hard for people to maybe grasp some of it, but it's done a lot of impact. Our website hits, our discourse members. If you look at the stars on GitHub, which is an open source, you know, merit badge, 482. Our code contributors just on our first repo is 133. And then another really cool development is we're about to have our fourth annual World MoveIt Day. Last year, we had 13 locations, totaling 310 people. People who are coming to physical locations to meet together and learn MoveIt and close issues. And so, yeah, that's coming up again next month. And we'll talk about that later towards the end of the day. And so from that, I want to hand it off to Mike to talk about MoveIt 2.